Recently, some research was published suggesting that bats could now possibly be the fastest flying organisms from the animal kingdom, and today I'm going to talk about what that means and whether we should be sceptical about that statement. When we think of the fastest flying animal, probably the first thing that comes to mind is the peregrine falcon. During their stoops, they dive headfirst from the sky down to their prey, reaching speeds of up to 389 km/h, the fastest body displacement any animal is known to achieve. However, this speed is greatly assisted by gravity, and the researchers were actually referring to speeds which are entirely attained through powered flapping flight, or level horizontal flight. When we think of fastest level flying, the spine-tailed swift is thought to be the fastest, as it has been recorded to reach speeds of up to 170 km/h. However, there is criticism for these figures, as the methods used to arrive at this speed are unavailable, and the figure of 110 km/h from the common swift, Apus apus, is much more readily accepted. However, this new research suggests that Tadarida brasiliensis, the Mexican or Brazilian free-tailed bat, could now be the fastest level flyer of the animal kingdom, potentially reaching airspeeds of 160 km/h. Unlike fruit and nectar feeding bats who engage in relatively slow flapping flight, the Mexican free-tailed bat is an insectivorous bat, which is commonly reported to reach speeds of up to 90 km/h. They normally go on nocturnal 50 to 100 km trajectories that consume up to a quarter of their body weight in insects and rely on their speed to cover these distances. Last week, a paper was published where some researchers tracked 7 different bats and reported speeds of well over 100 km/h, with one bat reaching 160. This is an incredible figure, and the way these bats fly is nothing short of remarkable, but unfortunately there are a few aspects of how this research was conducted that make me somewhat sceptical of it. Firstly, the tracking system they used wasn't ideal. The basic montage was a transmitter attached to the bat's back with 2 receivers on board of a Cessna aircraft which was flying above. The pilot can listen to the intensity of the signals from each receiver and use that to steer the aircraft above the bat, which is a technique that's commonly used to track animals over large distances, as it lets them take a position data point when the aircraft is directly over the bat. They were able to take measurements every 2 to 5 minutes, which were later used to estimate the bat's speed. However, these positional data points actually came with an error estimate on the order of 50 to 100 meters. That's quite large when you consider that the bat is only about 9 centimeters long, and that some of their consecutive location estimates were smaller than the error threshold itself, which I'd say is a pretty big red flag. Secondly, although most bats comfortably reached up to about 110 km/h, the largest speed of 160 km/h was a single data point, and they also had another outlier data point at 200 km/h, which they got rid of. Now, outliers are normal in science. Sometimes tracking systems fail and introduce weird errors, and it is normal to exclude them. The researchers claim that statistically, the 160 km/h could belong to the long tail of the distribution of plausible speeds, but the confidence interval attached to this value was in fact rather large. Their measurement of wind speed also left a lot to be desired. Tailwinds often help animals fly faster as they receive support from the wind, whereas crosswinds are forces perpendicular to the direction in which the animal is flying and can make them fly slower. These were not measured and instead were deduced from a 32 km wind grid of the area provided by their local meteorological station. Whilst this is definitely better than nothing, its resolution is nowhere near enough to deduce what's happening locally to the bats, and given they are so small, it isn't implausible to believe that small local changes in wind speed could significantly affect their flight speed. The researchers also claimed on the basis of the wind data they had that the bats seemed to lower their speeds when receiving wind support and sped up through crosswinds. Now, I actually think this is quite an odd result, because honestly, you would expect the opposite. I mean, it might not be entirely implausible, as there is evidence to suggest that some birds do apply the brakes to avoid going too quickly when supported by the wind, and perhaps they could put a bit more effort into overcoming crosswinds, but still, I think it's quite an odd result. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not necessarily claiming that this research is wrong, but rather that I'm dubious as to whether I would have arrived at the same conclusion as them, based on the data and the error margins they had. But sadly, stating that a new animal is record-breaking in some way is very juicy for news headlines. I think being sceptical often has quite negative connotations, but I do think that critical thinking is a fundamental part of advancing and bettering science, and I also understand that there are plenty of limitations associated with collecting and drawing conclusions from this type of data. For starters, although the paper was only just published, the data was collected all the way back in 2009. The tracking systems attached to the bats were around 5% of the bats' weight, who weigh around 12 grams, so the tracking systems are actually really small. We definitely have more sophisticated tracking systems today, but there's always going to be a trade-off in the equipment that can be attached to an animal and the equipment's weight, like I mentioned back in the cyborg beetle video and the drone video. Indeed, a better tracking system would have limited their positional error and could have measured local and wind speeds and direction, but those may well not have been available back in the day, and what they lacked in equipment they attempted to make up in statistical analysis. Nonetheless, even if they don't take the record for fastest flying animal, I think they can take the highest length specific velocity known for any vertebrate. This was previously granted to Anna's hummingbird, which at 10 centimetres and able to reach speeds of 98 kilometres per hour was 276 body lengths per second. These bats measure around 9 centimetres in length, and as long as they reach speeds of 100 kilometres per hour, they already outperform the hummingbirds by advancing at up to 308 body lengths per second. To give you an idea, if I could fly and did so horizontally, it would be the equivalent of me covering 475 metres in 1 second, a distance which would normally take about 5.5 minutes to cover at strolling pace. That's even more so than our dear friends the desert locusts, who are capable of reaching a constant airspeed of 33 kilometres per hour, corresponding to about 130 times their body length. I hope you enjoyed today's episode and learned something fun about bat flight and critical thinking. I also have some exciting news which I can finally say. I've been chosen for the YouTube Next Up program. I'm actually at the YouTube space right now, and when you see this video, I will probably be at the program. So lots of exciting things are happening. And as always, thank you so much for watching me, and I'll see you in the next one.